Here is how to do 90s like the pros, presented by Fortnite Master. This video is going to be our ultimate guide to 90s. We're going to give a detailed breakdown of the standard 90s and give some tips for perfecting them, then go into some different variations like the Infinite 90s, Mitro's 90s, and Mongraal's 90s. Disclaimer, that Faint underscore XO usually does the standard 90s, so don't take the demos of the other 90s you're seeing as perfect examples. Also, you'll want to stay until the end to see the fastest 90s in the game, VO's 90s. Without wasting any more time, let's get started. Standard 90s are probably the most commonly used 90s in Fortnite. The mouse movement feels natural, and once you get the feeling for these 90s, they become incredibly easy to do. We're going to spend the most time explaining the standard 90s, hopefully well enough so you guys can perfect them using just this video. But even if you already know these 90s, don't skip ahead, as we'll be touching on some core concepts that make 90s fast, which can be applied to other variations as well. Perhaps the two most important factors for executing these 90s is positioning and mouse movement. You want to be standing on the left side of your ramp, about halfway in between the middle and the edge. Then start doing the 90s about two-thirds of the way up your ramp. Starting your 90s a little further up the ramp will make them easier, but also a tiny bit slower, so decide for yourself which is more important. Next, you want to place your walls, then jump and place your floor and ramp. The mouse movement here is the most important part, so here's the hand cam of Faint underscore XO doing them. Once you get a feeling for the motion, it's really easy to replicate, but it can be hard to get that feeling for the first time. The best way we can describe it using words is to put your mouse down and right at about a 45 degree angle after placing two walls. Remember, you should be holding forward the whole time you're doing 90s, so try to get this motion down at full speed without letting go of any movement keys. A couple of problems that people commonly run into are Harry Pottering themselves, aka blocking yourself under a floor or ramp and losing too much momentum. If you're Harry Pottering yourself under your ramp, you're not getting enough height. To fix it, either start your 90s further up your ramp or do a better job of boosting out of your floor, a technique we'll explain next. If you're having trouble accidentally placing a floor above after a 90, work on your mouse movement some more. When you switch to your floor, your cursor should already be almost all the way down and right, near the end of your mouse movement. You also want to keep as much momentum as possible. A lot of players will consistently hit their sidewall while doing 90s. The problem is that this can slightly hinder your forward momentum. For max speed, try to keep collision with your wall to a minimum. To help with this, make sure you're starting your 90s no later than 75% up your ramp, and you're moving your cursor down and right fast enough. Now, we want to talk about one of the reasons why 90s are so fast that not many people realize. When you place your floor and you're still partially phased into it, the floor will push you up as it phases you out of the build. This boost is the reason 90s can be so incredibly fast and is the one difference between average 90s and the fastest 90s in Fortnite, which we'll cover later in this video. Note that going for this boost is going to make your 90s more difficult and precise. You'll likely Harry Potter yourself a lot more before getting faster. One tip to avoid this is to delay placing your ramp by a second. If you place your ramp too quickly, you'll Harry Potter yourself every time. And in order to execute this boost, you need to start your 90s about two-thirds of the way up your ramp. If you start them any later, you'll be too high up to be phased into your floor. Adding this boost into your 90s is pretty advanced and may take some relearning of muscle memory, so don't be discouraged if you struggle at first. Keep in mind that even the best players don't get the boost perfectly every time. Infinite 90s are basically just 90s with no jumping. We call them infinite 90s because you won't get jump fatigue, so you can do as many as you want in a row. You can also chain them together with any other type of 90 to make those infinite. Just do 3 90s however you want, then do a non-jump 90 for the fourth to reset the jump fatigue. Rinse and repeat. The positioning and mouse movement for these is very similar to the standard 90s. The one difference is that you have to do it much faster. For standard 90s, doing 3 in a row should feel like 3 smooth movements connected to one another. For these no jump 90s, it's more like a quick burst of building and mouse movement for each 90. Other than that, it's just a matter of breaking the habit of jumping every time and you'll be able to do these easily. Do note that even though the builds and movement for these are quicker, you still need to be as precise. If you're Harry Pottering yourself, remember that you shouldn't be switching to your floor slash ramp until the end of your mouse movement. These are faster, but you still need that slight buffer before switching to your floor slash ramp. Now, let's get into the EU90s, which uses a completely opposite pattern for wall placement and mouse movement. As far as we know, these are the same speed as the well-executed standard 90s, so choose which one feels more natural. These are also the 90s that FaZe Sway, one of the most goated controller players in the game, uses. For these 90s, follow standard positioning. About two-thirds of the way up your ramp, turn and start placing your walls following this pattern. Then jump as you build your floor slash ramp like usual. Notice how you can use your floor here to boost yourself up a little further, like we explained previously. You should be able to do this with all types of 90s, so keep that in mind going forward. In terms of mouse movement, you basically make a fast counterclockwise circle. One thing we found helpful was to pull the cursor down slightly after placing the final wall. As you can see here, it almost looks like Fane is just drawing a circle with his cursor. And be careful of letting yourself get too close to the center of your ramp with these 90s, as it's very easy to Harry Potter yourself doing so. Next up are Mongraal's 90s. Mongraal takes a different approach to 90s, using a more zigzag mouse movement. As far as we know, these are the same speed as the standard and EU90s. You want to start with the standard positioning, halfway between the center and side of your ramp, starting the 90 about two-thirds up. Place your walls in a zigzag pattern, like this, then build your floor and ramp. The mouse movement for these feels a little more jerky, like you're just whipping your cursor back and forth fast enough to get the zigzag pattern. After the first 90, you can continue doing the second and third the same way, using that zigzag pattern. Your other option is to switch up the consecutive 90s by using the EU wall placement or even standard wall placement instead. We've seen Mongraal do both, and to be honest, this is just another case of do whatever is most comfortable for you. You can actually switch up and combine the styles of any previous 90 we mentioned. There is no right way to do double or triple 90s, so if certain combinations of multiple variations feel more comfortable for you, go for it. FaZe Jarvis, for example, likes to start with a Mongraal 90, then go into two standard 90s. These next 90s, popularized by pro player Atlantis Mitro and perfected by Parallel Vo, are the fastest 90s in the game. But the reason probably isn't what you think. Before diving into why, let's start with a basic explanation. Start with normal positioning on your ramp, and about two-thirds up, make a hard right turn, immediately build two walls, then jump as you build your floor and ramp. Cursor movement is pretty simple. The only thing you need to worry about is pulling your cursor down slightly after placing the walls, so you don't block yourself with the floor above. If you haven't done these 90s yet, they may look like the easiest, but there are a couple of things that can be tricky. It's super easy to Harry Potter yourself with these 90s, so there are a few things to keep in mind that will help with that. First, delay your ramp placement. Unlike most other 90s where you place your floor and ramp at the same time, these 90s work better if you place your floor, then wait to place your ramp until you're at the top of your jump. This is especially important to executing the fastest 90s, a slightly more optimized version of these. The second problem you might have is falling off the edge of your ramp. With all other 90s, you have a wall there to block you, even though you should avoid hitting it. Mitro's 90s, you don't have that, so focus on being quick and precise with your turns as you start each 90. You should be making hard 90 degree turns as quick as possible on every single one. Your position on the ramp when you start your 90 also plays a role in this. You need to find that sweet spot between starting so low you can't get above your ramp and Harry Pottering yourself, and starting so high you fall off the side after your first 90. Finally, let's talk about the fastest 90s in the game, Vo 90s. You might be thinking that these 90s look exactly like Mitro's 90s, and you're almost right. Vo 90s are just a perfectly optimized version of Mitro's 90s. The thing that makes them the fastest is the boost Vo gets from placing his floor, a concept we explained in the first section of this video. For Vo 90s, you want to start further down on your ramp, just past the halfway mark. You can use the edit prompt as a reference. Turn to your right and place two walls, then jump and place your floor right away. You want to be slightly phased into your floor when you place it, so it pushes you out, giving you an upward boost. This boost gives you extra height and lets you land further up on your ramp. which is the main reason these 90s are the fastest. Here's a clip of Vo doing them so you can see what a perfect example looks like. Credit for these 90s goes to Parallel Vo and CNNR. Check out their links in the description. If you're interested in the exact speed comparisons between the multiple types of 90s, we'd recommend going to check out Parallel CNNR's video on the fastest 90s in Fortnite, which we'll link in the description as well. Thank you guys for watching this video. For those who are new to the channel, if you've enjoyed this video, check out some of the others on the right side of the screen. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell to get notifications for whenever a new guide shows up. You guys are great and we hope to keep making videos that you all like. From over here at FortniteMaster, my name is The Saved One and we're out. Peace.